Welcome to my channel and welcome back. Today we're going to take a look at the Pittsburgh Automotive, aka Harbor Freight, 12 volt, 150 PSI high volume air compressor. Had a red one, I think it was called Max Flow, a few years back. It was a great compressor, probably similar to this. It worked great as long as I kept it in the car. Well, I got a wise idea, mounted underneath the hood of my Yukon. And used the motor once when it was cold, and its motor heated up, sucked in all that moisture vapor, and locked the thing up. So, anyways, I need another one for the Yukon, and let's get this out of the box. Take a look at the time of this video. It was $69.99, $75 with Vermont state tax. Looks like it comes in a bag. Let me pull the bag out of here. Okay, I assume this is right side up. 10 would take it that the compressor's in here, and it is in bubble wrap, like Jim Carrey says in the movie Liar Liar, I'll wrap your knickknacks in bubble wrap. There's a hose. Okay, it's got a gauge built into it. That's different. On the other brand I had, the gauge was built into the compressor. Interesting. And here's what they give you on these ones. They give you the brass little thing. You screw it onto your valve stem, and I don't know what's in here. A couple different fittings. Let's get it out. Let's get it hooked up. I got to pump up those Yukon tires. Got a bead with a slow leak, and see how this thing works.
Okay, hopefully you can hear me. The little air compressor's got like a little diamond plated base. I got it running over there to my Jeep. Got it plugged into here. It's at 25 pounds when I just turned it on. We're up to about 26, 27. It's gonna be a slow process. I need to go to 45. So this thing says it'll inflate a car tire in 3 minutes. What's it gonna do to a 285 70 17 33 inch truck tire? How long will that take? Okay, we're on the passenger side tire. I walked away to go put the bubble wrap and the paperwork into the box of the truck. Turned my back, and the other side was at like 47 pounds, so close enough. Now we're on the passenger side tire, so anyways. Oh my God, literally, see the line on my finger? I burnt my finger touching that plate. Okay, I went to pick this up, move it back to the passenger side so I get a passenger rear tire. My finger accidentally touch that plate. The plate acts as sort of like a heat sink in effect, since it's bolted to the metal body cavity, and the pump comes out of here, through here, and I burnt my finger on it. I don't know if you see that little line on my finger, but man, that was hot, so be careful. You know, I must say, I'm impressed with this little thing. I pumped up two tires from 25 pounds up to almost 50 in less than 3 minutes. Thing is hot. Not big fan of this chuck. The cord is nice and long. I do like the air gauge here on this. That way I can drag this, leave the compressor close to the motor. It does reach the front and the back without having to go back and look at the compressor gauge on the old one that I had. So, and in here there is the little fittings for like a football valve, like an air mattress, things like that. So just what I kind of thought, but gonna let this cool off before I put it back in its bag. Yeah, it's definitely warm. I don't want to melt that bag.